I quadruple these dudes.
That's why I said it.
I flipping quadruple these dudes not make it out of this group. And I'm especially looking at Inter Milan. The group is looking wild. And this is why I love football so much. This is why I love Rio so much. Because people say, wait a minute, it's right for us to assume now it's Real Madrid. It's Inter Milan. It's Milan, Real Madrid. Of course, these guys are going to come through. It's going to be easy. Shakhtar Donetsk said nah. Mönchengladbach said nah. So we now have a point where it is conceivable. Not saying it's going to happen because it better not happen. It is that the boy Real Madrid and Tower Island could somehow not make it through this group. So we are heading into the first of what is going to be quite a monumental doubleheader. And I think the results of these two games could somehow have a major impact as to whether these sides come through or what the group is going to look like. So, and I think I love it because the thinking was, oh, Real and Inter Milan will come into this game with 6 points. But now that they haven't, it's now a case of where both sides now have to win. So it is set up beautifully, absolutely beautifully, for what I hope are two absolutely beautiful, amazing games. I think from Real Madrid's point of view, it's just a case of them. They have to, they're looking good, they're getting in there, and it's about building the team through Hazard. If they can get the best of Hazard, these guys can do something. I'm not sold on Vinicius. Asensio is suffering from his injury. Vasquez is from the road. Rodrigo is trash. So they need to really... Hazard is the guy. They only can go as far as Hazard takes them. And I think if Hazard is that, they can do something. If Hazard is Eden, we don't know. So if they can bring in the garden of Eden Hazard, then they can do something. In Milan, we're hearing that maybe Lukaku might be injured. So if Lukaku is in fact missing from this game, if he's missing from this game, advantage Real Madrid. I mean, it's because Inter are so Lukaku dependent. Literally everything goes through Lukaku. Even if he doesn't score, he's so crucial for this team's attack that I don't even know how they can function without Conte. But for Conte, I don't want to hear any excuses, because if you don't make it as a group, you can't blame it on, oh, Lukaku was injured. But why didn't he beat Shakhtar Donetsk or Mönchengladbach in your two games? Specifically, one of those games was at the crib. So nah, man, I don't want to hear any of that crap. So see, this is what I like. I like pressure. I told you, I'm a degree of difficulty merchant. Okay, call me D-O-D-M. Call me Dot M. Call me Dot M. Call me Dodum. Call me Dots M. Hashtag Dodum. Hashtag Dodum. Degree of difficulty merchant. I mean, degree of difficulty merchant. Hashtag Dot M. And that's what I like, because it's about, okay, the pressure is on. The pressure is on. Who will rise? Who will fall? Let's go into the dressing rooms to see what's that. Fuck off. No excuses. No excuses from you people. I don't hear any. I don't hear it. I don't hear any excuses from you guys. They don't have Lukaku. No excuses. You've got to go out there and you've got to say what's up. You have to go out there and you have to say what's up. Anything less, I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear any of that crap. So, don't you dare not make it through this group. A group that had, okay, Real Madrid, I get it, Shakhtar Donetsk and Mönchengladbach, and you can't make it through this group and you're Inter Milan. No. And you know, I like it. I pray Lukaku isn't available. I pray that he does not get fit for this game, because I will now look at you guys for you to now say, all right, we're going to say what's up. So can he say what's up without Lukaku? Because now I will now see what is the character of your team. Lautaro Martinez. I thought you were the dude that said, oh my gosh, I'm a Barcelona person. I'm going to play with Lionel Messi. What up? Come on. Release the Us. So, Lautaro Martinez, stand up. Be counted. Risic, what are you going to do? Stand up and be counted. Vidal, all of you guys are seasoned quality professionals. And this is where you now earn your wage. You earn your wage by saying, all right, our backs are against the wall. What can we do? We are Inter Milan. We have to live. Mourinho built this club. And it would be disgraceful to disgrace the goat by folding over like a bunch of absolute chimpanzees. So you need to go out and beat, because of course your father can be Real Madrid. This ain't the Real Madrid of old. They are very beatable. So you have to go out there with or without Lukaku and say what's up for that Inter Milan badge that your boy R9 Ronaldo helped to build and construct. So who the heck is going to stand up and who the hell are going to be a budget class guy? I swear to you, if you don't make it through this group, I'm considering building a wing. Karim, Vinny, I hope you've, you know, mended your differences. What does Real Madrid mean? Why is it Real Madrid? What does that badge mean? That badge means excellence. That badge means greatness. That badge means CL. If you spell Real Madrid backwards and you flip it over, what is the spell? Champions League. So that is the hidden code of what this badge is. That's the hidden code of this club. So it is your due diligence, nay, it is your due duty, nay, it is your birthright to win this trophy. So every single season, without fail, you are expected to do winner's max. That's what winner's max, winner's minimum. Really, that's what it's about. To be a Real Madrid guy, it is winner's minimum for every single CL season that you go into. Benzema, do your thing. Sergio Ramos, do your thing. Casemiro, please always say what's up. Rich. This is a big time. You're going into the first of a massive doubleheader. And you need to really ride like 3,000 phoenixes. Because you know what they say? They say Cristiano built this club. They say you can't do nothing without Cristiano. So prove to me that you guys can still be men without Cristiano. Because you know what they say? They say Cristiano owned this club. And Cristiano was the reason you got those shields. Prove to everyone that it wasn't just about Cristiano. It wasn't a one-man job. Everyone leave. Hazard stay. Yes or no? Simple question. Yes or no? Oh, sorry, you speak French, sorry. Facebook, okay. Oui? No. S'il vous plaît, choisis. I saw the G. That's what it is. I've been told by people. The streets have spoken. The streets said I am not allowed to celebrate. That I could jinx you. And the streets believe that I jinxed you. Are the streets right? Are the streets really correct and say that I jinxed you? Yes or no? Oui or no? Oui ou non? Are you back? Is sad back? Because then I've suffered. Nobody has rode for you the way that I have done. And I don't even want to go into words. Words cannot explain what I've lost. Trips to rehab, psychological evaluations. So what I need to know is that, are you back? Is it back? Can you ball? I read to write like Phoenix. Are you ready to become top three? Easy. Or is this just a flash in the pan? I need. So no. We were brought here for these games. This is the reason why we were brought here. We were brought here to ball in these games. They said I shouldn't say it. They said I jinxed it. I jinxed you. I don't believe in witchcraft. Well, sometimes. Obviously. The stage is yours. I will say no more. So, how do I feel this game is going to go? Inter, let me be pragmatic and be defensive, could catch Real Madrid on the break. Real Madrid, could they break down a very defensive Inter Milan side? Everything tells me this is going to be a draw. Everything tells me this is going to draw. It doesn't make any tactical sense for Inter to open up. And even if they did, Conte doesn't know how to, for them to open up. But I think Inter Milan's best chance is to have a very clear, concise, brave offensive plan. And Real Madrid, for me, I think they'll be expecting Inter to sit back. So they're going to just shove in. But even if you shove in, that ball over the top is always there. And trust me, even in their last game, even against Huesca, those through balls are on. And with the speed of Lautaro Martinez, that could be dangerous. For Benzema, I'm looking for that Benzema and Zad link up. Benzema and Zad link up. For Ramos and Varane, or Ramos and Ana Militao, they've got to be wary of those runs being made. Vasquez, how is he going to say what's up? So there's so many different battles in this. So it's very difficult for me to predict what's going to happen, but I will try. 1-1. It's a draw. Inter just going to... You know what? Inter may end up with 6 points in this group. They may end up drawing every single game. So, yeah, draw. 1-1. That's how it is. And guys, remember to follow me on Twitch. Follow me on Twitch to watch the match with me. Live watch along. Watch the match with Mar, HH. And, yeah, man. Remember to subscribe. And remember to hit that like button, man. We ride. Thanks for watching the vid. And remember to head to the official website for the latest on my blog, rankings, breaks, and the Hall of Fame on halffootballhot.com.